It's the Totally Awesome Trebuchet Awards, starring Trebuchet. On tonight's show, the sleep cheaters stop by. Also, the winner of this year's Chilifest competition. And now, please welcome to the stage, Trebuchet! Yay!
Come a little closer, everybody. It's time for a pair of TATAs to be jumping through your TV. It's time for the Totally Awesome Trebuchet Awards. What's up, Grand Rapids, YouTube, and what's up, GRTV? I am everybody's favorite siege machine. I am the one, the only, Trebuchet. Is that so right there? Also known as the guy who looks like Rob Zombie and Ray Romano's love child. Papas? Yeah, Rob wears the pants, but Ray folds them. They got a really nice working relationship going. But moving on from that, were the Rolling Stones in town this week, Trebuchites? No? Oh, I'm being told a Chick-fil-A opened up here in West Michigan, and it backed up traffic for about a mile and a half. 3 clucks for that. Do a little arm thing. We all know Chick-fil-A. They want you to put their hot, steamy, savory meat in your mouth, unless you're gay. Because as we all know, these cows are homophobic. What's wrong with y'all? Well, move over, Betsy, because gay people like chicken too. I know this because I am very in touch with the lesbians. Lesbians are the reason I get up in the morning. So we here at the TATAs are officially throwing our support to KFC, Popeyes, and even New York Fried Chicken. Because they don't care what you stick in your butt, just so long as their greasy chicken comes out of it. So get out of here, cows. Speaking of giant piles of stinky shit, the Seattle Seahawks logo, they eliminated the Detroit Lions from the NFL playoffs. Well, you know what, Seahawks fans? Your city rains all the time. Your donuts are weird, and flannel sucks. Hashtag flannel sucks. Graphic. Back to the Lions for a second. I know the secret sauce that they're missing. If they score more points, they'll win these games. They could even win the Super Bowl if they follow my genius strategy of scoring points all the time. Hashtag Coach Trebuchet is going to revolutionize the NFL. Graphic. It's a little bit longer one, but I don't care. Bam, love my graphics. So it's time to dust off a reoccurring segment, everybody. It's time for New Year's resolutions. Make some noise. Bah, 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 bah. Kicking off this segment, we got Miss Alexa Bliss. Oh, baby. Her New Year's resolution is to not be from Ohio. O-H-N-O. Sorry, Miss Alexa Bliss. Get out of here. Next up, Jesus of Nazareth. And his is to not be such a martyr. All right. Work on that. Up next, Charlie Sheen. We all know him. He doesn't have a New Year's resolution. We just want to say keep up the good work. Keep up the good work, Charlie Sheen. Just a quick recap here. Jesus has stuff to work on. Charlie Sheen does not. That's just what the show you're watching. Totally Awesome Trebuchet Awards. So moving on from that, next up we got Miss Ann Coulter. Oh, she's always fucking pointing at somebody. Her New Year's resolution is to figure out what the president does. Okay. Next up, we got Hoda Kotb, and her New Year's resolution is to find out what the president does. Okay, may want to figure that out. And finally, we have Donald Trump. And his New Year's resolution is to keep on having the best hair and figure out what the president does. So give a nice warm ovation for our New Year's resolution segment, everybody. We got a great show lined up for you tonight. We got the sleep cheaters in the house. Also on the show, handing out another Tata, we're gonna have the winner of Chilifest right here in the studio. So come on back, everybody, and we got more action lined up for you. Come on back. Welcome back to the Totally Awesome Trebuchet Awards, everybody. I am here with my guest at this time, the Sleep Cheaters, everybody. Give it up. Yes. Matt, Andrew, Timmy. We're missing a bandmate here, Ben, fourth member. What is he up to today that he couldn't come to our studio here?
Just bailing.
Well, he doesn't get out of work until a certain time. And I think the time that we're on right now... Mm-hmm. It's just conflicting.
He's working for the man. I got you. That's fine.
Stuff from the get-out.
We got to pay bills. Like, you guys aren't like
we're not
that,
successful.
You're not that mainstream.
We're not successful.
Well, you guys did make a music video recently, but we'll get into that. So you're emerging as a success story. But let's do a little band history here. Let's the Trebuchites here know a little bit about the band here. The Sleep Cheaters. What's up with the name? How did you guys come up with that?
Andrew, you got to...
Well, I came up that one night in my sleep, and
when you were cheating sleep,
I was actually cheating sleep. Okay. Actually, I don't know.
He's actually asleep. Is that considered cheating on it, or
that's the thing? That's the thing. You know, cheating in your sleep or doing illicit drugs to cheat your sleep. It could be anything other. I don't do any of that. But
you don't do any cheating when you're sleeping.
I don't do drugs. I don't cheat in my sleep. It's just two words that I put together, and I was like, you know, how about this?
It's very rock and roll. It can mean more than one thing.
Yeah, that's what I'm saying. It's for our fans.
Very deep.
It's for our fans.
That's awesome. That's what it's all about. That's why this show's on the air. That's why this band is on here.
It's not us.
It's for the peeps, you know. But, okay, that's a little bit about the name. How did the band itself form?
Didn't catch it.
How did the band form?
Yeah, how did the band form?
Matthew and I got together through a mutual friend, Ryan Pilot.
Okay.
I was watching the Amoebas. Matt played in the Amoebas, played bass for them. Mm-hmm. I'd come out to their shows whenever I could. And while I was in Chicago, I saw them, and then... Matt started hanging out with Ryan. They were buddies, and then Ryan came to visit us.
And introduced us probably for the second time, but we actually finally chatted.
Exchanged numbers.
Yeah. And you guys were like, hey, we should totally jam sometime. Like I saw you jam.
I think he was more interested in jamming than I was, but I was like, I need to have more. Like I need to have guy time. I want to play some guitars and be loud.
Right, exactly.
And then we
grunt a little bit, scratch, drink some beers.
I wanted to be serious and have a rock and roll band.
Okay, yeah, that's
you know what I mean. I wanted to just cut the crap, no jamming, just write songs.
Oh, you're just business,
It was him, and you know Matt played in a band with Tim here and Ben, called Attention Span. Okay. A lot of people like that.
So Timmy and Ben were in a separate band.
With me. Yeah.
With you. With Matt. Oh, okay.
Yep. So it's essentially that band.
And then they brought you in.
I feel like maybe I was the magnet.
Okay, so you
these
were
guys
the
would scrap some metal.
You're the catalyst, if you will, to the Sleep Cheaters.
Some
that's fine.
Together.
I like that. It's awesome.
Holy shit. So.
So that is the genesis of the Sleep Cheaters, everybody. I feel like Wikipedia should be fucking typing this shit out right now because this is history in the making.
And then cut out some words and then
change them.
Yeah, VH1 Behind the Music. I'm doing the work for you, so fucking write that check out to Trebuchet. But as I was saying, you guys made a music video recently right here in the GRTV studios. How did that go for you?
Great time.
That was actually a lot of fun.
Yeah.
Great time. That was really fun.
I can't believe how smoothly it went. Honestly, no. I thought it was going to be a many-day process. And, we got here late, and I think we took, eight takes. Mm-hmm. I can't believe how quickly those eight takes turned into the editing got, compressed into a good video. It was
fun. Yeah. You do take after take after take, and then you're gone, and then the magic happens, and then music video.
I did everything perfectly.
Yeah.
I think I screwed up on every take.
That's awesome. Yeah, that's part of the fun. You know, that's rock and roll. Like if you don't fuck it up, like.
No, it's Tim's song. He wrote a good song, and that's what we chose to record because it's a great song. We all like that song. So.
Do you guys want to go ahead and set up the music video here? Because we're going to go ahead and throw it into the show here.
Sure.
If you guys want to go ahead and just be all like, yo, this the name of the song, and then like, We're the Sleep Cheaters by it on this album, go right ahead and set it up, and we'll throw the video on after. Just do have a TRL moment, if you will.
Yeah. Mm. So this song is, go ahead, Tim.
The song is Good Company off the album Cheaters by the Sleep Cheaters.
Woo! Check this shit out! Welcome back from the awesome, awesome music video, everybody. But I'm going to take care of a little bit of business here. Matt and Andrew, you guys won these Totally Awesome Trebuchet Awards in the past, and I'm going to go ahead and present these to you.
Please, thank you.
Yes, and it was a very special moment for me.
I've been wanting this thing for a while
now. Having people fondle my TATAs right here in the JRTV studio.
Straight to the fridge.
That's awesome.
Straight to the fridge, dude. This is going on my... I'll get a good spot for it. Don't you worry about that.
Mine hang right over my mantle. That's where I keep them. The fresh TATAs. After I print them, I put them on my mantle, and then I bring them to the show, and then I hand them out to... Or have... people like yourselves hand them out to people like yourselves.
Oh, yeah. Of course.
So that's awesome.
Nice.
So enjoy my TATAs, guys. Cool, find them you. At your will. But go back into my questions here a second. Since you guys are musicians, you guys probably listen to a lot of music. Just curious as to a couple of bands that inspired you guys in the past, you know, just to maybe pick up a guitar or whatever.
I've always liked Jimmy Kravitz, No, I don't know who that is.
I'm like, is that
Lenny Kravitz?
I was going to say, is that Lenny Kravitz's brother?
Nah, sorry, Lenny. I don't like your nose ring, bud. But I don't know. Black Flag's always been sweet. Misfits are always been cool.
Yeah, so it's mostly punk music?
I've always been known to only like punk.
No, that's cool.
My friends think I was like, hey, man, this guy only likes punk. He's such a jerk.
Oh, you're that guy.
He's such a
jerk.
You
are that guy.
I'll listen to whatever. Bring me something. I'll listen to it. I'll probably hate it. But no, I like rock and roll. So
that's cool.
Just rock and roll guitars. I mean, I just like, I need guitars in my music.
Fair enough. Tim, Matt, you guys?
Let's go with the same answer.
Same answer? I mean, good answer. We're family feuding it up here. You're just going to go ahead and hop on him?
That's cool. There's plenty of bands that I definitely dig. And I go through different like trends, you know, like like this style of music for a while. It's all punk or offshoots of punk typically for
that's like, cool. Yeah, I listen to like music, I listen to everything. I'm all like reggae today, hip hop, punk, anything except for like country music, because I don't understand why Taylor Swift is so upset. I don't get it. I'm sorry. It's just like
I only really listen to the stuff that we create.
Oh, so you're strictly only your music.
Yeah, yeah. I don't really like
you
music.
Make all the music is
that's
what it
what
is.
I appreciate
okay.
That.
I really don't No, I don't know. I don't even really listen to a lot of punk, I don't think, as much anymore either.
No.
But I do, and I really enjoy it, and I've listened to it for years, but I don't know. I go in and out of things, I guess. I don't know. Mm-hmm. I'll try to get all over the spectrum and be, like, a little more versatile with music, because, I mean, I'm not going to wake up first thing in the morning and be like, fucking Black Flag, and just, like, start slashing my couches. Yeah, I'm like, I'm in a good mood today.
You got to have a cup of coffee first.
Then you put it on, you know.
It's a cup of coffee. That's what we're talking about. That's the theme
NPR
of the show.
Get my NPR radio in and then move on. That's good.
No, inspiration-wise, I mean, it's always been punk from my get-go, and, like, I'm just not that good of a guitar player.
Oh, that's cool, man.
So it's like, I with punk rock. I mean, are we punk? Are we a punk band?
Is that what the band is?
Last time
your band was on, Timmy and Ben classified it as waterbed music. That's what you would find it under.
Waterbed
so,
music.
You go to the record store and it's like it's in waterbed music. It's like right next to like Marvin Gaye, I think. Is where that was classified.
I wouldn't.
That's great.
Okay.
That's very select company, so I'd be I would be proud of that. I really would.
We're completely serious about that.
I am
it
too.
To do with,
I'm
like,
very
the name
serious.
Of the band actually said waterbed, right?
Yeah, waterbed music.
Peters, you know.
Yeah. It's like Serta Mattress is just going to be your guys' sponsor. Your next tour sponsored by Serta Mattress, and we're just going to be throwing I'm going to throw sheep into the audience at one of your shows.
Yeah, I'll call
I'm not in the band, but I'm just a big fan.
Is that a promise?
It's a guarantee.
Sweet.
PETA, don't come after me. I love sheep. I mean, nothing but respect to them.
You're not going to shave them.
That's good. No, throw them into the audience.
They're going to float.
Yeah. All right, one more question before I have you guys hand out this Totally Awesome Trebuchet Award.
I think this one.
The winner of this Totally Awesome Trebuchet Award can come here and claim this award, but you don't get this frame. If you take this frame, the sleep cheaters are going to come to your house, and they're going to rock out in your bathroom until you give the frame back. You don't want that, because they are really loud, and they will wake up everybody in your neighborhood. They'll do that
really
shit.
Really noisy.
But one more question, guys. Any upcoming shows that my trebuchites can flock to for you guys?
We do have some upcoming shows.
We do.
Let's do that. Let's hear where they're at.
We have March 31st at Firehouse.
Saturday.
Okay.
Saturday.
Or is it Friday?
It's a Friday.
It's a weekend.
It's a Friday. March 31st.
It's
is
on
Friday.
The weekend.
On
just
weekend.
Take the whole weekend off.
April 9th.
On the Sleep Cheaters weekend.
Yeah, that's right. April 9th at the Tip Top Deluxe Bar. It's a Sunday.
Sunday fun day show.
It's a Sunday fun day show.
I am so going to be there. Trebuchet will be in the house for that.
2 p.m. I mean, how can you pass that? It's a Sunday afternoon. Yeah. You just get out of church, come hang out with the Sleep Cheaters.
Bless
you.
Brunch.
Exactly.
After brunch. And then May 27th, we're playing It's Pyramid Scheme. With a couple different bands, Lazy Genius.
It's their release show, album release show.
They asked us to play, so we're gonna be there.
Rocking
another band.
Out.
Well, who else is playing? Lambo, I think the other band is playing there.
So come see these guys.
It'd be a good one.
Come see us.
Come see these guys. They're rocking out in the Grand Rapids area. They are the Sleep Cheaters. Pick up their album, Cheaters. That is on CD, cassette tape as well, I believe, right?
We're out of cassettes for our first album.
Yeah.
Just cassettes, EP. Not CDs. EP.
CDs for our current album. Plenty. A plethora.
CD.
All right.
By
Spotify.
Oh, and Spotify.
iTunes.
Definitely do that.
Spotify.
Plug any kind of social media because I'm at Trebuchet LOL on the Twitter machine. You guys got any kind of Facebook or Twitter things you want to plug in the meantime?
Sleep Cheaters.
Sleep Cheaters. Graphic right there. Sleepcheaters.com. Is it .com?
Sleep Cheaters at Bandcamp. Sleep Cheaters at Facebook. Sleep Cheaters at YouTube. Sleep Cheaters at your house.
We're going to get all those graphics up. But, all right, guys, down to business. Time for you to hand out this Totally Awesome Trebuchet Award. Here you go. I'll hand it to Matt, and he'll be your spokesperson because he's just closest to me.
Who are you going to give it to? Let's see. We've deliberated, haven't we?
We thought about it. We talked it over, and Walter.
Yeah.
Ben Walter.
Oh, I know him. I know him.
He's the drummer, and he's not here tonight. And he deserves this.
Ben!
Anybody else want to say
Yeah, you can
to
go
Ben?
Ahead and
say
give a shout out to Ben.
Ben, we miss you. We wish you were here. And we'll get those brakes fixed for you tomorrow. Okay, bud?
Yeah. I would have extended this couch for you, Ben. I have one more piece to this couch.
Congratulations, Ben.
Yeah.
I am now the only member that doesn't have one of these.
So give it up for the Sleep Cheaters,
Ben!
Everybody.
Sleep Cheaters.
The Sleep Cheaters and Ben. And come on back, and I will have my next guest. Come on back, everybody. Welcome back to the Totally Awesome Trebuchet Awards, everybody. I am here with my guest at this time, the winner of Chilifest, the incomparable Niner Wawa.
Wee-wa.
Woo! That's it right there. Wawa, wee-wa. How you doing, man?
Good. Good.
Two-time champion at Chilifest here.
Yep.
I am. It's amazing. How does it feel, man?
Feels good.
Yeah. Got two bona fide pieces of paper just chilling.
I do.
Being pieces of paper like they are. That's pretty cool.
Yep. Even one that's made on the spot and as a temporary replacement. Substitute until the real one came out.
Yes, exactly. Bona fide. I remember. Yep. Throwback to last year's Chili Fest. We're not going to.
Yes, it was. We
just watched last year's episode. It's a year ago. Niner was here. It's just deja vu. Are we living in the Matrix? Maybe. Maybe.
Perhaps.
But 2017, man. It's crazy. It's like January.
Yeah, it's finally getting nice out a little bit.
I know. It's kind of crazy, kind of like a mild winter here. I'm shocked. I'm all like, oh, no snow really. Cool. Yeah. I think I've shoveled twice this year, if that.
Yeah. It was a couple times, but too bad.
By that, I mean the people I live with shoveled the sidewalk. I don't shovel really. I'm a little bitch like that. I'm just all like, Planet Hoth, not my thing. But do you have any predictions for the upcoming year here, Niner? We touched on some New Year's resolutions earlier, but do you have any predictions here?
Predictions?
Or resolutions or anything you want to, get on the record here?
Gave up drinking. Trying that out for a bit.
Oh, yeah?
Who knows how long that'll go for.
Okay, cool. Good luck with that, my
friend. Maybe longer than I'm planning, but,
No, that's fine.
We'll see how it goes.
Awesome,
Already have seen a financial benefit, so
financial uptick because of that.
Yep.
That's awesome.
Yeah.
Good for you, buddy. I appreciate that. 1, 2, 3 claps for you. That's awesome. Don't forget to check out the Food Fest Hall of Fame where you can see this guy's mug two times now with bona fide pieces of paper on Chili Fest.
Oh, yeah,
that's awesome, man. You got lots of things going on in your 2017 here.
Oh, yeah,
sweet deal.
Been going good.
Exactly. You also got your special little segment, the Channel 9, going on here. You got any promises you want to guarantee to the Trebuchites or the Ninettes out there? Because I think your groupies are Ninettes. I think that's what we're going to call them from now on.
Okay. Yeah. I can go with that.
Yeah, the Ninettes, Wawa. When we say Wawa, you say?
Wee-wa.
Exactly. That's his thing. Ninettes, get it down. Wawa?
Wee-wa.
Exactly. It's just like that. But Niner is awesome because look at him. We're really close friends, but we don't want to sit next to each other. We see enough of each other. Yeah. We got a ficus right back here, that's right there, and then there's you know, if anybody else wants to come hang out with us, they're welcome to, because we're really friendly like that.
Yeah.
Like, this is for Jesus, I think. This is who we're saving this for. Oh, man. I mean, I got Thor's hammer. Like, you know, it's we're worthy enough to hang out with Jesus Christ, I think. Yeah. I think it's that kind of party here. Yeah. Anyway.
Keeping space. Space for Jesus.
That's right. Yeah. Exactly. There's that song, Jesus Take the Wheel. We're all like, Jesus, have a seat. It's just like that. But you got a pretty awesome t-shirt that you're wearing here, Niner.
Oh,
you got,
yeah,
like, Darth, yeah, Vader and Stormtroopers and everything.
Oh, yeah. I believe it's the Simpsons or South Park.
Cool.
Kind of.
Cool.
Maybe Legos. I don't know. It's something like that.
You've seen Rogue One.
I have.
Haven't you? I what have. Was your take on that? There's like lightsabers and all, like, ching, ching.
It was good. Like, it was enjoyable. Pew, pew, pew. It was, it was a little different from, like, the normal Star Wars movies, as it would go. It was more like I felt like it was more like the darker side of the rebellion.
Okay.
Which was nice.
Yeah, it has a really dark ending. Which Star Wars would you say is the most normal out of the series, just in your opinion?
The most normal?
Yeah, you said it's not like a normal Star Wars. Which one's the normal Star Wars movie to you?
I don't know. I mean, Return of the Jedi, I think,
that one's really good.
Is probably my favorite.
That's
one.
That's
good. Of all of them.
I'll give that three claps. I like A New Hope, but that's, you know, because that was the first one I seen. I'm a little biased on that.
Yep.
Yeah. And we're a little bit older, so we don't really care for the prequels. Like, producer Goad's like a Jar Jar Binks fan, but, like, you know. Don't quote Jar Jar Binks in the booth. He just said whoopee whoopee. Like, oh, my God.
Yep.
Yeah, this is the kind of crap we're working with over here. Fans of the Phantom Menace over here. Don't give me the thumbs up. Don't give me the thumbs up. But, yeah, Return of the Jedi is awesome, yep, because they blew up the Death Star again.
Exactly.
Are you okay with it being a bunch of independent contractors working on the Death Star? Like they say in Clerks, like, it's a bunch of, like, people building the Death Star because it's not fully built yet. Have you seen Clerks?
I have. It's been a very long time. I'm trying to think back to the
there's a conversation.
To the reference of that.
There's a conversation where they're all like, where Randall comes in and he's talking to Dante and he's all like, the second time they blew up the Death Star, it never really sat right with me. Because, you know, in the first time it happens in A New Hope, when they blew up the Death Star the first time, it's a bunch of stormtroopers and evil is punished. Mm-hmm. You know, I'm paraphrasing, but that's essentially what it is.
Right.
The second time they blow it up, it's not even finished yet, so it's a bunch of independent contractors and stuff like that, is what they're saying. Like, because do you think a stormtrooper knows how to install a toilet? No. You call on a plumber to do that. All stormtroopers know is killing in white uniforms. That's what it is.
Yeah, and marching.
Marching. Oh, yeah, there's marching, too. Yeah. Dun, mm-hmm. They're like only on public access do you get stuff like that. Like, well, Conan's not gonna give you that shit. He's just gonna fucking like have somebody else do it. No, I do fucking finger fucking motions over here. This is what we do.
Even on the fully completed one, there was still technicians and maintenance people who were keeping everything running.
Ooh, good point, Nine. That's a good point.
Might not have been to the extent of, like, having it actually built, like, the whole welding and installation and, you know, spacko on the walls and stuff.
That's a good
like
point.
That. But
you got to maintain stuff. I mean, the Death Star, it looks like a moon, so I'm assuming you have a moon-sized kind of community working on shit.
Exactly, yeah.
Like, it's a little bit socialist when you really think about it, Evil Empire. Everybody's got, like, their own thing, and everybody's, like, assigned a job to do. I don't know if there's, like, parallels in, like, politics in, like, Star Wars. Like, my teacher tried to tell me that, and I was just all like, you know what? I just like fucking looking at lasers. So you can kiss my ass, my fucking teacher. But all right, Niner. That's all the questions and jargon I have for you for now. Now it's time for you to hand out this first of the two Totally Awesome Trebuchet Awards. And you can hand this sucker out to anybody you want in the entire world. But the winner can come down here and collect it. But you don't get this frame. If you take this frame, we're going to send producer go to your house, and he's going to do nothing but quote Jar Jar Binks. That's what you get. That's what you get. Here you go, Niner. Can hand that sucker out. Oh, it's a reach.
Well, I had one. I had thought about one, but now I kind of wanted to change it a little bit.
Oh, really? It's not official until you say it on the Tatas, Niner. So you get this, it's official as soon as you say it here.
I think I might need a what this stands for again. Like a recap of what it stands for and what it's meant for.
Oh,
before, because I want to make sure it'll actually apply.
Okay, I'll explain a Totally Awesome Trebuchet Award to you. A Totally Awesome Trebuchet Award, or Tata, if you will, is what we hand out on this show two times, because Tatas come in pairs, obviously. And it's just a way for us to recognize people who do things that we see, honestly. It doesn't have to be a good thing or a bad thing. It's just things that we see with our own retinas and whatnot, and we hear with our fucking ear drums and whatnot. So it's a Tata, and we're going to give out another one later. So there's not just one Tata. There's two Tatas. There's parrots of Tatas. It's fucking... You need to have even numbers is what I'm saying, a Tata. So that's what we're doing here. We're trying to hand out pairs of Tatas to people. You only get to do one, but
yeah.
The guest after you hands out another one. Does that make sense to you, Niner?
Yeah.
Okay. Yep. I got so heated I had to put on sunglasses. I was just like going to shoot lasers with my eyes there for a minute. But yeah, go ahead and
okay.
That's what it entails.
The person I would like to hand out this Tata to is, it's Trump, to be honest.
I'm going to clap three times because I always clap three times for people who win Tatas. Go ahead and explain yourself. Why does Donald Trump deserve a Tata, Niner?
Well, I mean, his Twitter feed's been pretty interesting lately.
His Twitter feed's been pretty interesting. Okay, I'll give you that. I'll give you that.
He talks to the Russians, but everybody denies it. So, I mean, he has people behind him who are doing things for him, I think, maybe? I don't know. It'd just be interesting to talk to the guy, I think. You know, try and understand where he's coming from with some of these tweets.
Okay, I get it. Now, you're trying to get him in the studio here so he can come here and collect that Totally Awesome Trebuchet Award. So, Donald Trump, you can come here and you can collect that Totally Awesome Trebuchet Award, but you do not get that frame. If you take that frame, producer Goad's going to come to the White House, and he's going to do nothing but quote Jar Jar Binks the whole time. So I kind of want him to take it. I kind of want him to take it now. So come on back and witness more craziness on the Totally Awesome Trebuchet Awards, everybody. Come on back. Okay, ladies and gentlemen, very first Chilifest shot right here. What are we doing right now, D? Dice and onions?
Dice and onions.
All right, she's getting a Rachel Ray on right now.
Next will be the garlic.
Garlic is next.
Yes.
All right, more to come later. We got crackers rolling here. Oh my God, excitement.
He looks better now. All right,
now D has officially got a pot out. She's got some hamburger in here, some tomatoes.
Kidney beans.
Oh my God.
Garlic powder, tomato sauce.
Smells delish. Yeah. Chili Fest is really heating up here, literally. So you got flame on here, it's heating up.
Yeah.
Okay, everybody, so far I've tasted these chili, and so far you're winning.
Oh, okay.
But that's the only one I've tasted so far, so. Now we're on tried Keith Niner's chili. He's number 9. Go ahead and, put that over there, take a look, enter that one. Oh, going around the room here, oh my God, this is what Chili Fest is all about. It's going around the room here, it's crazy in here. We got Niner's chili, we don't have 9 chilies, but this is Keith Niner's, he's over there. And then Hannah, this is yours right over here. And then D's is number 1, which is over here. I'm gonna crack open this Jägermeister in a minute. Chris, go.
Oh yeah, we're doing Jägerbomb, like right now.
Cornbread.
Jägerbomb.
All right, D, we got all of the chilies in. This is Niner's. Hannah's over here.
Here's some Hannah finals.
Voting's going on.
He's the greatest of all day.
The greatest of all day. Nate Dogg.
Has everybody that's voted tried all the chili?
That's the idea. Make that announcement. They have to try them off for voting.
I don't know. There's a lot of questions like that, right? At the end, it's just a story.
This is Tim and Rachel's over here. I have yet to try this one. It looks good. We got Tim and Rachel's chili right here. Oh, look at that shit. Look at that. Bam.
Chips get sucked.
Smells like some
Jamaican.
That's
Roy's. Oh, look at that shit. Oh, yeah.
Timmy, this is Timmy in the flesh right here.
Hey, this is...
Hey, Joe.
Get out of the way. We're going.
God.
We're live on the air, Timmy. We're on the air, everybody. Getting some good chili footage. Oh, I'm sorry.
Oh, man. Niners.
Yeah, Grumpy in general has a tendency to be like, hey, this
is Joe again, chili!
Part two.
And this
poor Brad
and
Snacks Booth.
We have tallied the votes, and our 2016 Chilifest winner has been figured out. First off, in third place, Roy.
Yeah.
Fish shark.
In second place, my mother D. And the winner, once again, Niner.
Oh, you win a bona fide piece of paper.
Yeah.
You get to be interviewed on the Totally Awesome Trebuchet Awards. You just watched John Cena make history.
Oh,
what
yeah.
do you have to say for yourself, Niner?
I'm going to Disney.
Woo! Yeah.